G'day and welcome to my garage.
It's a casting of one of the release crank levers. Came out very nice. A little bit rough on the back here, but that doesn't matter. It's got to be machined down to thickness. Half inch, 12.7 mil. So just got to make it now usable. Won't take long to file up. Okay, we now have two little men. These are the crank lever release lever cranks. Get that right. Beautiful. I now have to go and retrieve the pillow blocks from the casting sprue and clean them up also. Get back to you later. Okay, I'm now cutting the pillow blocks out of the away from the sprues and stuff. I've recovered one, filed it, got it looking reasonable. This journal only needs to be about 3/4 of an inch long, but I've made it 1.5 inches. It's it's easy enough to cut down later if necessary. But for the time being, yeah, I've cut it at 1.5 inches. So my process now is to cut the second one away. That pretty good. So I'll wrong file to start with. Try that again. I'll bring you back later. Well, like usual, I end up going too far on it before I bring you back. But this piece is nearly finished. Only as far as being finished for getting it ready so I can machine it. So there we have the two pieces. Yep, they're very close to the same size, so there we go. That'll work for me. They came up pretty good. Yes, in places the casting's a bit rough, but this surface here and the sprue here, they get machined down to, the sprue gets machined down to size, about 1 inch, if I remember right, and then I'll just clean up that that inside face there, or that top face. I'll leave that. I've got to clean up the bases eventually to get them the same level, but that's with a file. Put that on a, what does he recommend, putting that on a mandrel and then filing a square. But yes, they're ready for machining. I will see you then. Let's see. Let's try that position. Thank you. Now, can we reach the centre? Yeah, we'll just reach it. Okay, I just have to finish the last little bit with the drill press, with the hand drill, because it just didn't quite make it. It was hitting the I could hear it hitting the jaw. What else have I got to do? This could be bored. Maybe. No, it doesn't have to be bored. I have to step my mandrel. Not by much. Later on it has to be bored. Okay, I think I can take this out now. Alright, that'll do for the moment. We'll be right back. Well, the cone I was machining a little bit earlier, that's this one here. It centralises this bearing pillow block, so it's running true to axis. Now, I've machined this down to, should be 30 millimetres, I'm pretty sure I've done it. Yep, 30.25 millimetres. So now I need to reduce the outer part of this to 25 mil. So that'll be a shoulder from 30 down to 25 mil. So that's it. This fellow. Alright, so let's engage auto. Close enough. Not close enough, but spot on. 10, 20. Twenty-five oh eight. So that's 02, 02 5 05. Hang on. I lost it. Do that again because I I measured the diameter and I started moving the cross slide in relation to the diameter measurement, not the radius measurement. So. This doesn't have to be critical to the left at a 25.1. Okay, we're spot on 25 minus 0.03. So we're 0.03 of a mil. That's one and a half our undersize. So this little man will be bored out to 30 plus a little bit millimetres and slide over that. Then a washer, I've got a, this is at 22 mil, I've got to take it out at 25, that'll slide over the end of that. So I will put in my cutting tool, cut off, the parting off tool, make this a bit more accurate. And here we go. So I'm just under 25.
I'll zero this wherever it is. Now I've got to go 25 down to 23, that's 2 mil. I've got to go in 1 mil.
Let's see what we're at. Hopefully, should be at 23. And 22.97, spot on.
That's 5 millimetres. That always moves when I lock that in. Okay, we're on the mark.
And I ended up, I wanted to chamfer on it last time, so I stuck this one. Stuck this fellow in. And I chamfered it and cut it off. All in the one go. That's it. So, let's see what we've got. We'll just clean this up. Just going to file that edge off. That was pretty neat. I've got the ring groove in there. I know it works because I did the other one. Decided to go this way, mounting this thing to the faceplate, center it, bore this out 30 and then mount this into the air blade.